that should inform everything we do that might have an impact on.
Can we each other start?
We might get a little closer.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay, pick up where we thought or?
Yeah, we heard.
Okay. Safety of the air must be protected, and that should inform everything we do that might have an impact on. In July of 2010, in an historic vote, the United Nations General Assembly declared for the first time that access to clean water is a fundamental human right. And just last month, Judge Gisela Triana ruled in a district court of Texas that the atmosphere is part of the public trust. Even the DCEQ itself recognized that water is a part of the public trust. What does that mean? It's been recognized since ancient times that government must protect certain resources for the common good, resources that support us all and the destruction and degradation which hurts us all. Where the government fails to protect our air, water, and soil, it's failing to protect our very lives, like we pay the fire department and police department to do, and it's forfeiting our future. By knowingly allowing actions that benefit the few at the expense of the public, at the expense of our health and life itself. We, the people of the city of Dallas, expect, deserve, and demand that our government step up and fulfill its obligation to protect us and these public resources. Too many of our citizens have not even been informed about this debate and how it really will affect them. It's amazing how many we run into every day that are shocked and dismayed that our city government is considering it. I and many others call for true public hearings to be held out in our communities around Dallas so people can be properly informed and discuss the issue. Mr. Mayor, we would, I know there's not a quorum here, and I turn to my comments for you, but we would like to know when we can expect that to take place. Thank you.
Bravo.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me. I'm David Wiles, 2318 Beatrice Street, Dallas, Texas. I'm here representing Fort Worth Avenue Development Group. With the benefit of having observed those cities and municipalities who have gone before us allowing hydrofracturing operations within their communities, having watched last year's Magnet 1 disaster unfold in Waxahachie, and observing the news reports of the frequent tremors and seismic shifts in the Cleveland area and the DFW, the Fort Worth Avenue Development Group is opposed in principle to any and all hydrofracturing within the Dallas city limits. However, should fracking be permitted within the limits of the city of Dallas, Fort Worth Avenue Development Group recommends the following limitations and safeguards. Since water used in fracking operations is permanently removed from our drinking supply, there should be a ban on the sale of municipal water to drillers for hydraulic fracturing or fracking of gas wells. All fracking companies should provide Dallas's emergency first responders a full list of toxic chemicals used in their drilling operations, regardless of trade secrets. This list should be provided before drilling operations can commence and in any event before an accident can occur. To prevent environmental degradation of recreational areas and to preserve their potential for public enjoyment, hydrofracking operations should not be permitted within Dallas parklands or floodplains. To protect public health, property values, and quality of life, setbacks from any location where Dallas residents live, work, worship, and play should be at least 1,500 to 3,000 feet from gas lease property lines, and any variances with special use permits required should be limited to a maximum of 500 feet. To safeguard against triggering earthquakes, disposable injection wells should not be permitted inside the Dallas city limits, period. To effectively regulate fracking operations in Dallas and provide help to residents 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, an industry-funded Dallas Office of Gas Drilling Oversight, with trained personnel and equipped with the latest technology, should be established. To comply with the Dallas Climate Action Plan, drilling companies should be required to offset any climate-changing gas emissions. To pass any future gas drilling operations, we recommend that a two-thirds approval vote of the city council should be required. In addition to city council hearings on today, August 1st, and on August 15th of this year, the Fort Worth Avenue Development Group supports several additional city-sponsored, citywide public meetings in the evenings to receive public input. I thank you for all your time, and I appreciate you considering these matters.
Mayor, this thing is for you. It was set up to use the dais in the other room. Don't know how well it's going to work here. But this is all going to make your wait and all work, by the way.
There's something wrong against stunts or something, but that's the way it is.
This is a science demonstration. Just do that. Let me see if this works. Jim Sherbeck, Dow Leaders at Risk. I've been involved in the policy and politics of clean air in Dallas since 1989. And during that entire time, there's been at least one constant. The city of Dallas has been the most dependable municipal friend clean air in North Texas has. Today, you're confronted with the most serious challenge to that leadership role that I can remember. I'd like to offer you an answer to that challenge, one that I'll hope you'll consider. Earlier this year, we saw the successful conclusion of the green cement procurement policy that Dallas created and pioneered right here in this room. It permanently removes 300,000 tons a year of greenhouse gas pollution and smog forming pollution upwind of Dallas every year, while cement manufacturing in Midlothian is actually increasing. This is exactly what the policy was meant to do. And you can repeat that success with gas pollution as well. The policy here is called offsets, but it's really about maintaining and restoring balance. Every other industry coming to do business in DFW must reduce as much or more air pollution as it's estimated to release. That's because we're in a non-attainment area. We violate the smog standards. Except the gas industry was left out of this provision of the law. Not because there was a lot of debate, no, because no one even anticipated urban drilling when these laws were written up. A small loophole is now a large one. The state estimates, as you heard earlier today, oil and gas sources release more smog-forming VOCs than all the cars and trucks on DFW roads. And it's not just VOCs, it's NOx as well. Don't let them get away with that. Even a quarter of that amount would still be huge. This pollution is becoming an albatross around our lungs. Even while pollution from cars and kilns and coal plants go down, gas emissions are going up. It's canceling the progress we would otherwise be making. For a short period of time, we pushed these illegal levels of air pollution through the northwest Tarrant County, but now that's not true anymore. They're coming back east. And just this year, a monitor at Mockingbird and Stimmons, that Hidden Street monitor, is out of compliance for the first time with the 97 ozone standard since 2005. We are going backwards in terms of air quality. You need to restore the balance there. Right. You need to offset these. As part of the new gas ordinance, you can implement an offsets policy that grandfathers all current sources, only covers those already not covered by other programs like this, and only deals with greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases are smog emitting gases, and you get a threefer out of this: toxins, smog, and greenhouse gases. Think of it as a cafeteria. You walk in, if you're a gas operator, you have your annual tonnage, and according to Mr. Ireland, it's not going to be any tonnage at all, so it's not going to cost you much to offset this stuff. You pick from column B, you make it match column A, you walk out, you check out, and you get your job done. Listen, it's not a way to control technology. It's not saying you can't drill. It's just restoring some balance. Please think about this. We want you to win, and this is an air quality issue. I'm right there with you. I think this is the most important thing, and this is a way that Dallas can be a leader in the country on this issue. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gallagher.
Bravo.
Hello, I'm calling on 1716 Chandler Place. Mama, we need some help. I mean, we need you. I know you might be pro Hispanic, but son, we need some help. Blacks, you know, colors, they need some help too. And so, that's one thing that the people in the neighborhood wanted me to come down here and address was the swimming pool, because 100 and some degrees, and I'm thinking about the incident that happened in Dixon Circle. You know, we had an incident like that to happen in all this park. And bothering me, okay, my 2-year-old was throwing a temper tantrum, and he knocked the lady downstairs, or pitched down, or something. She always say that he knocked some stuff off the wall, which means it ain't properly put on the wall. Okay, well, she did, well, she came up there and told me about it, then she called the Dallas police on my 2-year-old. And then I asked him, I said, well, did she tell you that it was a 2-year-old that made the noise? She just told him that it was noise in the apartment, not a teenager. And I don't have a teenager. But my point is, you know, I don't know, there's a lot of stuff going on and we need some help. And really, the pool, she don't put, open the pool back up and call herself cleaning. And we don't understand. So they want me to come down here and address that with you because they said the lady over there don't care about this. So we want, I'm trying to see if we're, okay, now, according to the issue with the Dixon Circle issue, okay, we got a problem with y'all shooting down our people. This is out of control. Okay, so John Mullen was shot in the back, and he was from Oakville. Mr. Caraway, he was from Oakville. John Mullen was shot in the back, and on a police stop.
Thank you.
We want our people, we want y'all to stop shooting our people down.
Kyla London, not present. Lakeisha Johnson, not present. Catherine Colden. Ms. Colden will be followed by Dwayne Wooten, Esther McElfish, Frank.
Thank you for allowing me to speak with you today. I appreciate hearing from the guest speakers, and they have had very insightful information. I wanted to address air quality concerns that have been discussed here today. While many drilling opponents have claimed that drilling will severely damage air quality, their claims are not backed up by science. Several studies of air quality have been completed in our neighboring communities and have shown that claims of air quality damage are fabricated. A recent $1 million air quality study conducted by the City of Fort Worth revealed no significant health threats from the Barnett Shale drilling operations. The Texas Commission on Environment Quality surveyed approximately 220 natural gas production sites in the Barnett Shale and concluded that there were no widespread air quality issues. Additionally, Titan Engineering conducted a study of air quality around natural gas sites in Fort Worth and Arlington City Council District 2 and found that no harmful levels of compound were being emitted. It is also interesting to hear environmental opponents of drilling for natural gas viciously oppose production of an energy source that gives off about 30% less carbon dioxide than oil and just under 45% less than coal. If we are so concerned about carbon emissions, it would seem logical to promote a fuel source that would significantly lower carbon emissions, wouldn't it? The fear mongering among opponents of drilling is very troubling. Non-biased entities have studied the air quality issue and have found no issues. The bottom line is that we must have energy to power our lives. Natural gas gives us an abundant domestic energy source that is much cleaner than other fossil fuels. It has been drilled safely in our neighboring communities, and the same can be done here in Dallas. Thank you for your time.
Dwayne Wooten.
Good evening, Mayor. My name is Esther McElfish, Mayor and Council Members. My apologies. My name is Esther McElfish, 3511. I love Drive. And I'm here tonight. Council Member Marvin is my representative. I wrote the DART earlier. I just recently moved back to my hometown of Dallas. I'm 18 years in Fort Worth, and one of those reasons was the gas drilling. And I'm here as an individual, but I want you to know, Mr. Calaway, Council Member Calaway, that I did put my pants up on the dart rail and make sure that I took care of that provision. I also want to give you a little hint on the West Nile virus, and I mentioned this to Council Murray Myers, that you can put vanilla extract, believe it or not, on your arms as an organic gardener. I just thought I'd share that little tidbit to enlighten you after a very long council meeting. You may be aware of an organization, NCTCA, the North Central Texas Communities Alliance. I was the co-founder and first elected president for the last 2 years, and I want to give you some insights. I'm going to share these insights very quickly. my card and talk to you individually. I'm here today as an individual citizen, a citizen very happy to be back in Dallas, and I'm very concerned about what's going on. I'm going to highlight a couple issues very quickly, and I would ask that any of you that would like to meet, I would be happy to do so. I have met with my council member, Marlon, and I would like to be able to share time. We've got a little more time than 30 seconds here. We've covered several issues, and a couple of the things that I wanted to address very quickly. The money issue, the industry will always flag that. Look at the money. I just want to give it a reality check. The reality is the average payout is $30 to $35 a month. And you have to pay taxes on that, and it nets out $20 to $25 a month. Yes, there's some big ticket folks. But let me ask you a question. When Fort Worth is breaking in all this money, how can we even close all the pools? How can we have a $75 million shortfall in the budget? Answer those questions when you're so flush with a lot of money from the gas drilling, or maybe it's just creative bookkeeping, I don't know. There are a couple of issues, and Mayor, I agree with you about the air quality issue, and I would welcome, when we have more time, I'm going to come back and address on the 15th. The air quality study was very flawed in Fort Worth. A couple of the sites were tested, where they put the monitors. They said they had six, they actually only had five. They had two of those sites out by Sphinx Airport, south of town, almost to Johnson County. They were not in the neighborhoods. They did not test where you would see these results in the effects of the neighborhood. And I speak from personal experience. I lived on the east side of Fort Worth. And here's how the industry operates. When they came and they signed, and we signed leases in 2008 for a three-year lease, we specifically, 1,200 households said, please, we do not want drilling in our neighborhood. Don't worry about it. We'll do across the highway on A20 and 30 or in this open land. They went out 6 months later, bought land under an LLC, not under their company drilling name, bought it in our neighborhood, and I had a well within a mile of my house and a half mile of my school.
Thank you,
Mayor, and I'll be back to address you also. Thank you so much for taking the time to speak.
Good evening. My name is Luke Metzger. I'm the director of Environment Texas. We're a nonprofit advocate for clean air, clean water, and open spaces with almost 1,000 members and the activists here in Dallas. We were supportive of the drug fracturing disclosure law. The legislature last session were involved in that, and there are a lot of problems with it. Mayor Rawlings, we agree with you that it's a travesty that the companies are hiding behind trade secrets. Unfortunately, they still are. An analysis by the Texas Observer found that on the Frack Focus website, still at least 15% of the chemicals are being classified as trade secrets. The public has the right to know what they're using, and if the companies are so assured about the safety, they shouldn't be afraid to tell what's actually being used. You also mentioned the insurance risk, Mayor Rawlings. I think it's interesting, Nationwide Insurance recently announced that they're not going to insure fracking operations because there is too high a risk, they said, of an accident and other problems, and it's not worth it for them to insure. It was mentioned about the study that the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality did as far as the air emissions from fracking. The specific study was actually found that 113 tons of VOCs are released every day, which is equal to that of all the cars, trucks, forklifts, locomotives, every moving vehicle in the Dallas-Fort Worth. And that's especially troublesome for the almost 15,000 children here in Dallas County that suffer from asthma. We have too many air quality ozone days where children are literally struggling to breathe, and so it's a very serious concern for the air quality from this. Water has been brought up, so it's estimated that about 25 billion gallons of water are used every year, at least for last year, for fracturing, and just in Fort Worth, about 2.5 billion gallons of water. I applaud this council for your steps recently to adopt mandatory water conservation lawn watering standards. I think a lot of the public would say, well, we're doing our part to save water, and it's one of the worst droughts in history. What do the gas companies do? So one step I'd recommend is requiring that the companies recycle the water they use. That's a practice common in Pennsylvania, but it's not really being used here in Texas. That would be one way to address the huge water use by the companies. You've heard a lot of the varying studies of what's a safe setback level, anywhere from 300 to 2,500. The fact is we don't really know whether there is or what the safe distance is. One thing I'd recommend you look at is what Longmont, Colorado, recently did, a big
adjacent to the vast infinity we call space. Excuse me, I waited almost 5 hours for 3 minutes of your time. Can you please, please, not be rude? He gave an analogy, I'm talking about Jack Glenn. He gave an analogy in which he stated that the diameter of the Earth was the height of his body. The layer of air around it would be about this thick, just a few millimeters. Think about it. How precious this wonderful life-giving layer of air is. Beyond it, there's nothing but the vacuum of endless space. Ladies and gentlemen, our little layer of air is being abused. It has no voice. And so I am here to speak for it. By trade, just up until last year, I was for the past 25 years a traveling saleswoman around the state of Texas. I wholesaled optical frames and I carried large, heavy sales rep bags. Because my home office in New York only paid me $50 per night for a hotel, I tried to look for inexpensive Motel 6 types of places, and I would always ask for a room on the first floor that opened up to the parking lot. This way, I could carry in my sales rep bags with less difficulty. On two different occasions within the last several years, once in Houston, once in Odessa, I was awakened in the wee hours of the night by noxious, toxic gas fumes. Evidently, in Houston, a refinery was dumping poison into the air around 4 or 5 a.m. These fumes were so strong they woke me up, and I'm a pretty sound sleeper. A few years ago, I was in a motel on I-20 in Odessa. I remember waking up in the middle of the night, like 3 or 4 in the morning, because my eyes sensed they were burning. When I opened them, they were really smarting. There was a horrible strong gas smell in the room. You can literally almost feel it. It was sort of like a visible foggy vapor. I assumed the room had a faulty air conditioner spewing poisonous fumes, so I ran to open the door to let in fresh air. But when I opened it, it was much worse. It was the outside air. I quickly closed my door and looked around in horror. My eyes were still really burning, and I was having difficulty inhaling. I jumped to the phone and called the front desk, but there was no answer. So alone and afraid, in an attempt not to breathe it in directly, I simply got under the covers and used my sheets and blankets as a face mask. I lay in bed thinking, this must have been what the Nazi gas chambers were like in Germany. It was so surreal.
Thank you.
I only have about 30 seconds. I indulge 30 seconds more.
Please. Thank you.
Your final speaker is here, retired chief. Not present.
I drove in from Arlington. I've waited 5 hours. I have a lot of experience.
No,
please, may I talk?
But you gotta sign up.
I didn't know that when I got here.
Sorry. You speak next week. Just sign up.
I'm not driving away, seeing my.
That's okay.
You could very.